Hey folks, here is the second part of my interaction with Symbiosis and student, in which I had presented my smart ring project done for Titan watches. But before that, if you haven't watched the first part in which I had presented my system design project, so you can find the link on the top right corner. So let's move to my Titan's project.
So in exchange semester when Titan came to campus, and then I wrote them a project proposal that Titan should do something in the smart domain field, because being a watchmaking company, they don't have any specific brand for smart wearables, you know. And that was a very niche where smart phone making companies are entering into, and there are even luxury brands which are now coming with analog smartwatches. So that was the initial thought that, okay, why not pitch Titan for this domain? I selected my proposal and then I got in. During the initial days of my research and project scope, I realized that just having a smart watch making attitude will not work, because Titan is not having any brand. You know, for a set brand, it will be an incremental product. But a company which is not having any specific brand for that kind of product. So it all started with what is smart. Everywhere, all the products were like tagged with smart, you know. And then there are so many questions which those smart wearables can't answer or can't provide what they actually promise, you know. So there was over promise from the brand side and under delivery, you know, like buy this smartwatch and then your lifestyle will change, and then blah, 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 you know. And actually, when you buy this, after the initial bubble of the technological wowness will float here and there, then you will just simply throw that watch here and there and then not use it. Or else, if you are very specific user, something like that, if you are athlete or something like that, then you will keep using it. But for a normal maximum spectrum of user, they will simply just get away from that initial wow factor of tracking fitness, tracking steps, you know. After a point, I inquired that 10,000 steps mean nothing, you know. It's just like a redundant information which a watch or device is giving you every day. So there was a need to define and come up with more meaning to these numbers, you know. And then it started from there. So I came up with so many questions, you know, why this and that, and without any answers. So just questions, you know. That was the initial starting kickoff of that project. How we define the smart factor, what is the intelligence in that? So these were the questions. And then there were so many verticals as well, like more data, more truth, more data, my responsibility, and then more connection, better communication. So these were things, contrasting verticals, which I was really observant about while doing the research, initial research. Came up with an initial brief and presented to Mahendra Chauhan. He is the head of design team right now. At this point, I had no clue that I am going to come up with a smart ring or something like that. There was no direction. It was that is the beauty of Titan's design team, that they don't push or show like, okay, you have to create this or something like that. So I was really lucky to have that kind of vision from the managers in Titan. And then I studied what is the wearable ecosystem around and what are the dynamic stakeholders involved, what hardware components are required for these things to create, you know, because that was my first project into smart domain. And then I did a stakeholder mapping exercise again for this, and then studied the market, how Indian market is behaving, you know, how the overall sentiment is moving in what direction. And then the wearables in Titan, they tried few of the SKUs in their brand and they failed. They didn't perform well in the past. You know, they collaborated with HP as well, but it didn't work well for them. So that was also a constraint to just keep in mind. You have to be very careful if you are stepping into this domain. Product offering which were into smart domains, and what went wrong, what didn't work out. So these things were mapped out. What's being offered at ground level, what's being over promised and under delivered, these things were mapped. And then product positioning matrix was done. So for smartwatches, for smart wearables, this was a grid which I came up with. And then the conclusion of it, what is the grid coming all about, where Titan should place their product. So these were the outcomes of the design research to help them create a brand elements and even the elements which will go into their future product lines as well. So these elements were scalable for them. So in future, if they want to come up with a, they can pick a target and they can pick the insights from this document and they can simply scale it up and apply and enter. Then understanding the concept of time, because Titan is like in the business of time, you know. So it was a parallel track also to study what is time, what are the different philosophies of time in different cultures, you know, Indian culture, Egyptian culture. So there are different types of typologies of like how they define time. So that was also a very interesting study. How in Vedic system time is defined. They have their own unitary system for reading and measuring time, you know, and that was a very interesting read. So I inquired how we can connect tradition with the modern science, you know. So that was the direction which was building up at this stage. So carried out few of the user studies, how many watches they have had in their life. So complete journey, what were the decision points and the drivers factors affected their subconscious mind that, okay, these were the reasons which build up even going back to 6 months of their history. You know, if they bought the watch today, I went around 6 months back in their lives, you know, what happened and what were the drivers which helped them to make a decision to buy a particular product now. So this was also an exercise which was parallelly happening. And then coming up with design workshops, again to break away. So these were a few concept cards which were created to test the assumptions and validate them or break away from them. And these were the outcomes. So these are the rankings on the website. And then coming up with a core, secondary and tertiary card. So the systems learning helped me in this project. So in the center, there are so many features which can go inside a smartwatch. All of them are necessary or not for the user. So that was a question. So this exercise helped me to rank them and see what priority is for the user, target consumer. So this was a very interesting insight outcome from this exercise. And again, this was scaled up to carried out with students as well as professionals. And the data points were compared from these two segments so that Titan can make a decision what target segment they can take on. And then I came up with feature insight grid. So this was like a kind of ideation session based on these insights. So again, this was carried out for each, like for design styling, for water, sweatproof, and there are so many verticals which was in depth again inquired, you know, activity tracker, what should go inside, what should not go inside, what is working, what is not working, what is over promise. All these were like inquired for each and every vertical. And then at the end, I came up with different persona cards, you know. At the end, like if Titan has to blindly pick one persona and scenario and give a design brief to their design team, how they should go about. So this exercise was helping them to combine all the elements from the design research activities and methods into one persona envisioning document. So these were different segments which were targeted and elements were put down. The problems faced by that particular segment. And then envisioning the scenario of that particular persona. Or what's happening in their life and what are the latent needs, you know, because if you directly ask from the user what do you need, they will always capture their conscious mind. They won't be able to give you the hidden insights which is happening in the back of their mind, you know. So it's very important as a designer to bring out the subconscious, you know, tap and document what's not evident on the surface. And then these are like normal design CMF direction, design philosophies, and also inquiring about the RASA theory, you know, in Indian system, there is a aesthetic system. So how we can amalgamate the modern design philosophies with the ancient design philosophies, you know, which is already there, but it's not branded as a design aesthetic philosophies, but it's already there. I came up with octagonal grid to judge the aesthetics of any form, you know, the ideation part. So coming up with a very futuristic concepts was the key idea, because immediately Titan was not going to launch the product. So 5 years ahead down the line, what should be the product line? So that was the whole direction. And the main outcome of this project was all these outcomes from these co-creation workshops that will help Titan to build a brand into smart home. So the Ring project and the smart tracker project are just one or two examples which were done to show the potential of the research. So I came up with a concept where with tweaking the accelerometer, you can measure the vibration of a particular device. If you are ironing in your cloth, it will project certain vibrations with that particular material, or if you are using a power drill or something like that. So that vibrations can be measured with accelerometer. So tweaking that, you can come up with a micro interactions, you know, and that will help you to naturally perform certain activities. Right now, with screen-based interaction, it's very difficult and it's like overburdened, burdening the device that, okay, in that small real state, you have to control so many things. So why not you do the way you do, like in a natural setting? So that was the whole idea for the first concept. So normal, like flick and then tap, touch, grab or something like that, operate or twist or something. These micro movements of your wrist and hand can be measured, and then that can be scaled up for performing different activities in connected ecosystem. And the second one was the Metis ring. Why this? Because Titan already have Tanishq, which is into jewelry. Titan is already a well-reputed brand in the field. And so I tried to connect all these elements with the tradition quotient and the modern factor into one product. So that was the whole idea of bringing this product and then redefining the brief for this product, you know, these two concepts as well. These are the few detailed. This is again another level of deep diving into that domain, because if you are picking something up, then you will have to learn what it's all about, you know, and how you are finding a perfect balance between the tradition and the modern science, and then make it relevant to the target segment which you are making it for. So that was very crucial, you know, finding the right balance so that it won't become very gimmick, or it won't become over functional so that it will miss out. So at the end of this project, the form of the design was like, the concept was not very important. What you are putting in as a soul was very important and crucial.
There is a concept from a video for Metis ring.
Yeah, and there are a few small good projects which I keep doing on and off and posting it on Instagram. And few of them luckily take a form of a full-fledged project, you know, like the OJ blood testing device, which was also published on Yanko Design and few of the newspapers as well in India. So, and also working in a corporate, you are not allowed to make a full-fledged business, you know, so that's sad, but yeah. So keep exploring, that's the idea actually.
Thank you, Anshuman. The presentation has been very informative and insightful on what process, like how the process should be followed for designing. So let's move on to the question and answer session.
So here the second part ends, and we'll be releasing the third and last part of this series, in which there was an open interaction with students' body and answering their questions related to design process and my approach towards design. So please stay tuned, and thanks for watching. Peace.